Welcome back to my channel, mga kawandos. This is a follow-up vlog doon sa previous vlog na nagmamadali ako doon sa previous vlog natin on vaccination rollout sa Davao City. So previously kasi they were preparing the vaccination sites by having a dialogue with the district health officers. So medyo naayos na yun yung sa district sites. Ngayon, with the private hospitals naman, hospitals in general sa Davao City, yung discussion to prepare the vaccination, upcoming vaccination. So ngayon, may makakausap tayo ngayon to explain to us and to maybe motivate, no? Kasi medyo mataas yung hesitancy ng vaccination pa for now, to motivate people to yung magpabaksin. So ito na nga, so kausapin natin ang mga taga City Health Office ngayon. Wow, this will be our very fruitful time for us to have this rich information. So here we go. Good afternoon, Doc. Doc, briefly, Doc, paki-introduce sa iyong sarili and what's your role dito sa City Health Office or sa vaccination program natin.
Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Jelinda Acosta. I am the chief of the technical division of the City Health Office, and I'm also a member of the Davao City Health Office vaccine group. No, mm-hmm. I am under Dr. Ashley Lopez, our City Health Officer.
Okay, no.
And also with me under sa administration sa vaccination is Dr. Jane Colanis, because we have different subgroups in the COVID-19 vaccination program in Davao City.
Wow.
So just now we had our meeting with the private hospitals. We discussed to them the simulations that we had last February 16th having vaccination site at Mabini Public School. Part din sa discussion is we finalized the master list of priority beneficiaries in the hospital. Priority vaccinees sa kailang hospital. And also, especially those staff na handling COVID patients. Sila yung the first priority. And of course, we also discussed the substitution list, because we know that the vaccine is para yan siyang, sabi nga ni, if I borrow the statement of Secretary Duque, na para siyang Duque, para siyang gold, no? Na dapat hindi siya masayang.
So, very briefly, introduce yourself and your role here.
I am Dr. Michelle Mabil-Boscatos-Losser. I am the assistant of Dr. Jules Acosta. I am also a member of Vaccine Nation Cluster as well as the Contact Tracing Cluster. So actually, these are the agreements that will be discussed by Doc Acosta regarding the vaccination rollout in Davao.
Oh. So ano lang, Doc, a general impression lang, kasi parang parang itong meeting na to ay designed talaga to parang get the feel kung paano yung participation ng mga private hospital. So ano yung description mo doon sa parang ano nila? Excited ba sila for this or willing ba sila to cooperate?
I think everyone is excited to have this role of the vaccination, kasi this is the most awaited part of the pandemic.
Uh-huh.
Kasi kung meron ng vaccine, I think people would feel like things are going to go back to normal. So I think very receptive naman yung mga private hospitals natin. And they are very willing to help the City Health, kasi it is a reality that it's a huge program. So talagang kailangan natin ang help ng isa't isa, especially those that private hospitals.
Oh, so may agreehan na kayo, Doc, with the
yes.
So sige, let's talk about the agreement.
It will be discussed by Doc.
Sige, let's start. Anong number one na agreement, Doc?
Our agreement with the private hospitals is sila po yung magkakonduct din sila ng initial counseling, kasi having seen the pictures in the simulation, sabi nila na baka magka-crowded tayo doon or matagalan tayo doon sa counseling.
Mm-hmm.
So they will do the initial counseling of their staff.
Doon pa lang sa kanila, yung mga candidate for vaccination will have a counseling.
Counsel na nila.
Uh-huh.
At saka magkaroon na rin sila, magbibigay na rin sila ng medical clearance to their vaccinees, yung mga staff nila. Para hindi tayo matagalan doon sa vaccination site.
Uh-huh.
And each private hospital will provide at least one JC consultant or resident doctor and respective ambulance during the vaccination schedule.
Ah.
So magpadala po sila ng kanilang doktor.
Oh, okay.
And each hospital should prepare priority and substitution list of vaccines.
Ano ibig sabihin nun, Dok? Substitution?
For example, sa priority masilis na schedule for today na bakunahan,
uh-huh,
and then hindi nakarating kasi baka nilagnat,
okay,
or may mga other conditions. So meron silang substitution na staff na ipadala.
Ipadala,
rin. Hindi po masayang yung allotted na vaccine for that particular vaccinee.
Ah.
And then another is, hospital will schedule their manpower to be sent to the vaccination site. So sila na yung gagawa ng schedule ng kanilang staff na due for vaccination today. Parang
okay,
hindi naman sila mawala ng manpower na mag-duty sa kanilang hospital. So kanilang responsibility yun. And every hospital, they have volunteered, no? They really cooperative. Na every hospital is a referral hospital for the adverse event following immunization.
Oh, okay.
Hospitals will coordinate with the city health office regarding the referrals. Although we have identified one hospital which is near the Magbini Public School, the Seventh-day Adventist, pero para hindi ma-overwhelm din ang Seventh-day Adventist Hospital, then each hospital in the city will be a referral hospital.
Ah.
So yun ang di-commit nila. Okay. And then hospitals also will help us monitor the post-vaccines for the AFI for 1 year.
Ah, matagal pa rin yung monitoring, no?
Yes, oo, kasi bagong vaccine kasi siya. And then the Central 911, it was also suggested kanina in the discussion that Central 911 and the double option and the DOH option and SPMC to filter the AFI online consultations.
Ah,
like
so
for example, may mga consultations about regarding AFI.
No? Oh.
Then we have the 911 and double option, DOH option and SPMC.
Ah, so ang ano niyan doon, halimbawa, nagpa-vaccinate ako, tapos may mga na-feel ako na ano, parang kakaiba. Pwede akong tumawag doon sa?
Yes, sa hotline.
Hotline.
Central 911, uh-oh, and then double option, DOH option, and SPMC. And I think it was suggested also kanina,
uh-oh,
I think that we will have also the private hospital hotline, pero meron kasi yung bayad pa sa hotline.
Sige to, ilagay natin dito sa screen yung ano ha, yung mga contact numbers ng mga for consultation.
Ito yung mga free consultations natin, yung mga 911, double option, DOH option, SPMC. Ito lang muna ang ating online mga AFI consultations.
Ah, okay. Sa private, wala pa sila?
Wala. Pag private kasi may bayad kasi yung online.
Sige. Salamat, Doc. Doc, satisfied ba kayo din sa mga agreements dito ngayon o may kulang pa?
I think everyone is up for the challenge, man, sir. So, even the private hospitals are looking forward na maka-help talaga sila sa vaccination rollout. So, I'm pretty much excited for the rollout itself, sir.
Okay, Doc, may sabi kasi na mataas pa daw yung hesitancy. Ano ba yung message natin to address that?
Actually, yeah, we would like to acknowledge that, Doc, that there are hesitancies. But I hope that the public will accept this program.
Mm.
And I think it will be addressed through education information campaign by the DOH, by the City Health Office, and the rest of the medical personnel in Davao. So I think when the public will see this, na medyo set up na talaga siya and it is well prepared, I think the public will accept the program itself.
Doc, misses natin sa mga healthcare workers na sila yung magiging priority. Ano yung message natin sa kanila to motivate them? Kasi may mga hindi pa yata nagpa-enlist.
Kasi this is voluntary, no? So depende kung mag-consent kayo. But I think there's a need really to be vaccinated because this is one way of preventing getting the COVID-19. And we know that immunization talaga is a way na para hindi tayo magkasakit, no? Oo. So anyway, we will enhance our IEC mga education namin sa kanila para maintindihan talaga nila kung how important is vaccination is.
So ang sabi kasi nila, Doc, yung mga sa community, sabi kasi nila kung hindi 100% yung efficacy niyan, hindi na lang ako kasi hindi rin pala ako covered. Oh, paano natin no, i-ano yan?
I think even in other vaccines that have been given for such a long time, wala naman talaga tayong masabi na 100%
okay.
ang kanilang effective protection, no?
Oh.
But still 85% protection or what is very good. It's very good na na para hindi ka tayo.
Better than zero.
Yeah, better than no protection.
No
at
protection
all.
At all.
So I encourage ko talaga na everyone should receive the vaccination.
Okay. So ano na lang doc yung mga ano how do we medyo burn out na yung mga health workers ngayon, di ba? Because of the ang dami nating pinagagawa to address this issue. Paano natin sila ma-encourage to keep on parang going?
Yeah. So, yeah, for a year na kasi itong COVID-19 and we're still fighting na talagang mawala na talaga itong pandemic
dito.
Ano lang, talagang encourage ko pa rin na na-surrender pa rin tayo.
No, surrender!
Surrender pa rin tayo and oh. Then we really have to work harder.
Okay. Dalawa na yun, Dok. Huwag tayong sumurinder.
Work harder pa.
Ayan. Ikaw, Dok, may message ka to the general ano population.
For the general population, I know that most of us are very keen to social media, pero I hope that you will not believe everything that you have heard in social media. Because the City Health Office, together with the Department of Health and the rest of the medical world, is really finding ways to put a stop of this infection. So I hope you will just have give us a little faith na mabigay to marul atong vaccination program natin so that everybody could go back to their lives and as much as possible a normal life.
Thank you sa inyong time, mga doc. Thank
that
you.
That won't ever break, sir. That won't ever break.
Wow. So, yun. Okay. So, thank you very much. And I hope, tuloy-tuloy lang yung ano. I hope mayroon kayong lakas para ituloy lang itong ano ginagawa natin.
Okay,
thank you. So, mga kawandos. Yun na. Naarinig niyo yung ano, dalawang magigiting natin ng mga doctors galing sa City Health Office. So, I hope ma-address natin yung fear natin doon sa vaccine. Yung ayaw pa natin ganyan. Kasi ito na yung solution na matagal na natin pinangarap. So, this has been Wandos. Salamat. Thank you for watching. And if you like this video, ayan, comment down below and click mo naman yung like. And then, kung hindi ka pa nag-subscribe, please subscribe para ma-update ka sa aking mga bagong videos and hit the notification bell para pagka may bagong uploads ako, ma-notify ka agad. So, this has been Wandos signing out.